There is more disappointment and delay for NASA this morning, with the space agency's moon launch called off for the second time in a week.
This is a live look at the Kennedy Space Center, where, as you can see, that rocket not really moving much, in fact, firmly grounded on planet Earth. Nine US correspondent Amelia Adam also grounded in New York for us. Amelia, what went wrong this time?
Well, technical issues, Jenna and Belinda, good morning. A leak specifically, crews found a liquid hydrogen leak while they were fueling that giant space launch system, the rocket that was due to blast off this morning with the uncrewed Orion capsule stacked on top. And despite several attempts to resolve the issue, teams simply could not stop the leak. And so roughly 3 hours before the launch window was due to open, it was scrubbed. And it was a different leak than the issue that caused Monday's launch to be scrubbed, but still very disappointing, as you say, for NASA, the second time in a week. They're holding a briefing right now at the moment. They have been very keen, NASA, to just emphasise that this does happen very regularly. Space shuttles, rocket launches, they scrub, they delay, because it literally is rocket science, and after all, safety is the number one priority.
This is an incredibly hard business. This is an initial test flight of this vehicle. We're going to fly when we're ready. And as part of this initial test flight, we're learning the vehicle. We're learning how to operate the vehicle. And we are learning all of the things required to get us ready to fly.
So there are a couple of options going forward. If this leak, this issue can be resolved while the rocket's on the launch pad, then it will make the next opportunity to blast off, which is in 2 days' time. If the teams there decide they really need to roll it back into the vehicle assembly building, which could happen in order to fix it, then we're looking at a mid-October launch. So we'll probably know more about that decision in the coming days, but it is very disappointing for NASA. They've poured so much work and, of course, billions of dollars into this Artemis program, which ultimately will aim to return humans to the moon, hopefully in the next couple of years. But of course, Jenna and Belinda, all of that really depends on the success of this first unmanned mission. So everyone very keen to see it get off the ground safely as soon as possible.
Safety first, of course. Amelia Adams, thanks for the update.
Another setback for NASA's return to the moon. This morning's Artemis I launch called off for a second time this week after a fuel leak was picked up. So where to now for the world's most powerful rocket? Let's bring in Glenn Nagel from the CSIRO NASA tracking station in Canberra. Glenn, I mean, it's best to be safe than sorry, but you're part of the Aussie team involved in this mission. How are you all feeling this morning?
Oh, look, our team here at the CSIRO, we kind of have always professional excitement rather than disappointment. This is another step on the road to getting that Artemis rocket off the ground and on its journey to the moon. So let's see what happens now. It's really up to the mission team to have a look at the problems and see how quickly they can resolve it and get us on that journey back to the moon.
So engine problems caused the first launch to be scrubbed, but just explain what happened this morning.
Yeah, so this time during the fueling operations, they were getting a high indication of a leak at about sort of three times the rate that they would sort of normally accept a small leak of hydrogen gas. So from the bottom of the rocket, the connection point, putting in that fuel, just a little bit more of a fuel leak of hydrogen that they'd like to see. So that basically said, let's be cautious, let's not go. There's a chance of ignition, unwanted ignition. And so it was basically scrubbed the launch for today.
So when could we next see the next launch date? Will it be third time lucky? Cross fingers.
I'd like to think it's going to be third time lucky, but if it's fourth time or fifth time, that doesn't really matter, as long as they do it when they're ready, when it's safe to go. Everybody needs to remember this is a test launch of a brand new vehicle. It's never been tried before, this kind of rocket, using the best of technology we've developed over the last 60 years, but bringing that all together, you know, it's not always going to prove quite easy. It literally is rocket science. So let's hope in the next week or so we'll get a new revised launch date.
And that end goal, though, to get humans back on the moon.
Yeah, humans back to the moon, not just a bunch of guys this time, but, of course, to put the first woman and the first people of colour on the moon. That's still set for 2025. So let's look forward to that and let's get off the ground first with Artemis 1.
Yeah, well, it's been 53 years, so what's another few years? Glenn, thanks for your time this morning. Jane.